Now, you guys may have thought you knew which season in Fortnite was the best, and when it comes to this discussion, there's usually two different types of people. Well, there's the people that are gonna be like, season one, only OGs remember. Like, yeah, dude, remember this skin? I was a part of this!
Oh my god, I'm so elite. I paid money for a default reskin before they even had a budget to make real good skins. Yep. Alright, well, the point is, there's people that have nostalgic attachment, and then there's the people that actually know what they're talking about and understand what the true best season is.
Welcome back to Top 5 Gaming, everyone. We're today, and today only, we're breaking down the Fortnite seasons ranked from worst to best. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and if you should want to buy anything in the item shop, don't forget to support us using code T5G in the item shop. Huge thanks to Moot for sponsoring the official Fortnite ranking series. Their app lets you meet and squad up with people on all types of games or just find lounges where people can hang out and talk about games they all love. Want to find some friends to squad up with or just learn more about Fortnite updates? How about you join our open lobbies? Click the link below to sign up to Moot. Thanks to Moot for making this series possible. But with that said, let's get into it. Number 8, Season 1. So I can already tell that some of you guys are triggered from me saying this, and once again, these are the people that are just having that nostalgic attachment. The very first season of Fortnite's Battle Royale, objectively, was a much simpler time compared to what you see today. The seasons have evolved in ways that not many would have seen coming. But even with all the other seasons getting new weapons and biomes, no one who was around since the early days of Season 1 will ever forget it. The first shot accuracy mechanic hadn't been introduced to the game yet, so there was a massive sense of bloom in the community, probably more so than it is today. However, with it being a brand new game for everyone other than the Save the World players, the new and innovative building feature was something no one could resist. At the time, the map was completely green, with a much smaller amount of points of interest to explore. For Epic Games, this game was blowing up, though, and for the community, well, we just couldn't get enough. It was the first major Battle Royale game for console players, and it was free. This was a game that a lot of people would happily pay a normal game's worth for, but it wasn't just a basic free game. It was really well thought out, suitable for all ages with an almost Minecraft-esque style to it in a battle royale environment. It was the combination that we never knew we needed until it suddenly showed up. As the season progressed, though, we soon realized that there was a lot more coming. This wasn't a game they were just gonna chuck on the shelf and barely update. We got so many updates that it just felt like there was something new around every corner. And obviously, they had to add in that report button for the amount of hackers and team killers showing up at the time. And yes, team killing was a thing back in Season 1, and yes, I may have team killed some of my teammates out of rage, but we don't have to talk about that, okay? It didn't happen. It didn't. No, I mean, I don't really think it's too big of a deal because everybody was just kind of joking around anyway at this point in the season. I mean, nobody could build. Everyone was pretty much a bot. I'm still a bot to this day, though. We also got our first seasonal event for Halloween showing off the pumpkin launcher that allowed the community to first discover rocket riding. The bush item showed up and launch pads were introduced, as well as the first 50v50 limited time modes. However, this was just the beginning for Fortnite Battle Royale. Because in at number 7, we've got Season 6. Holy moly, we just skipped a bunch of seasons. This is one of the more recent ones, so most of you may have got to actually witness the return of Kevin the Cube and the floating island. Tearing itself from Loot Lake, this island has its own tornado surrounding it, allowing you to pull your glider and float up to the island in the sky. It was a brand new mechanic we hadn't really seen before, and a massively fun one for everyone at that, even more so when people found out that you could send people flying across the map by getting Kevin the Cube to zap them or yourself with his pink lightning. Now, Season 6 itself brought us a lot of items like the chiller trap, balloons, pets, and even the quad crasher. One of the best updates for a lot of people were the introduction of the epic and legendary variants of the pump shotgun. There were also corrupted areas around the map with shadow stones and pink jump craters, which combined made for some very fun tricks. Now, the floating island was a great asset to the map, traveling around most of the map before returning. But what I think a lot of people would say is Season 6's downfall was Fort Nightmares. For the Halloween event, we saw giant zombie producing crystals around the map that could spawn randomly throughout the game. They were pretty handy for some free loot or shield, but not many were a fan of them, and getting in the way of battles made the game feel more RNG based, and obviously they're always constantly trying to change the game, so I could see where Epic were coming from, but it was kind of a giant sack. Number 6, Season 7. It was the season to be jolly, and to be fair, the season started off pretty nicely. We all had brand new Christmas skins, including an actual Santa, and we got the new wrap customization for your weapons, and who could forget a giant iceberg that completely demolished the entire southwest corner of the map. We now had Polar Peak, Happy Hamlet, and Frosty Flights as the new main areas. There were even the brand new planes that everyone couldn't wait to try out. For a moment, the season was doing really well. They even decided to introduce their first mythic weapon, the Infinity Blade. It was a lot of fun if you got your hands on this thing. However, it was just found to be too powerful and endgame victory victories against this thing was insanely difficult. It didn't really make a lot of sense, so they eventually removed it. We did, however, get a whole bunch of new items, some only temporary for the winter season, though, like the sneaky snowman and the chiller grenades. We also got the scoped revolver and the suppressed sniper rifle. I mean, let's not also forget about the boombox and bottle rocket. It was a lot for them to add, which was fun for the most part, but pretty soon the community began to realize just how powerful the planes had become. People used them to camp out till the last circle or simply third party at the last possible moment. It became such an issue at the time that not many people can rate the season highly due to the planes alone. But in number 5, we've got Season 5. It was the very first season that introduced a whole new biome, the desert. The rifts in Fortnite's time and space had transported locations throughout time from our world and teleported some things from Fortnite's realm into our world. I said our world twice. Is that allowed? Is this allowed? The Bega head could be found in the middle of the desert area in California, and llamas had been spotted all over the world. This changed the Fortnite map heavily. We had Moisty Mire and the prison area completely replaced by a giant desert biome and the introduction of Paradise Palms. The dirt track had now been replaced with a completely revamped racetrack. We saw Lazy Links appear at the north end of the map, and even what people refer to as Viking Village on the west side of the map. You could even find Easter Island statues all around the map and rifts everywhere, with them bringing in golf carts, as well as this made for a very fast-paced and travel-friendly season. Season 5 also brought us the now-loved heavy sniper rifle, double-barrel shotgun, and the suppressed assault rifle. We even had the drum gun for most of the season. For weapons, it was actually a pretty good time. They also added shockwaves, which just added to that fun factor. But what made Season 5, for most people though, was being able to watch and have fun in Kevin the Cube's adventures. The whole community just wanted to support him, eventually reaching his destination at Loot Lake and giving the phrase, "I'm bunny hopping across Loot Lake," a whole different meaning. But in a number 4, we've got Season 2. Now, Fortnite decided to really step up their game with Season 2, proving to the community to just how much work will continue to be put into the game. Previously, the entire west edge of the map had been empty. They added Snobby Shores, Haunted Hills, which had a bit of a rusty start, but they fixed it, and then Junk Junction with its adorable but giant metal llama. They added Shifty Shafts, a whole bunch of other named locations, and who could forget the infamous Tilted Towers. Fortnite gave us so many locations throughout that season that just kept everyone happy. However, they had also gone just as overboard with all the items and weapons as well, lucky for us. We saw small shields and the Chug Jug, impulses and boogie bombs, and Fortnite were clearly showing us how crazy things were going to get. And that's when they went and introduced the minigun, being able to blast through any builds you were near unstoppable until people learned to counter it. Then we were fine. We also saw the Valentine's event with the introduction of Cupid's crossbow. Overall, the season was non-stop adventure and action, but just in time before all the major biome changes. Number 3 is going to be Season 8. So Season 8 is where we are right now in the present day of Fortnite. And how are all of you finding it? Because we've been having a lot of fun here at Top 5 Gaming. We knew there was going to be Fire King and Ice activity going on, even a possible volcano, but not many saw all those pirates coming too. It's turned a lot of the map into a literal beach paradise with Lazy Lagoon and Sunny Steps, plus the giant volcano. The entire area is a tropical wonderland. I just love the pacing. The new pacing with all of the updrafts and being able to quickly move around the map in combination with the cannons. Fortnite have even brought in birds that fly around the skies. The first time to see some sort of animated animal in the game, which shows just the lengths they're going in order to create an amazing environment. We've seen a massive reduction in rifts with so many of the geysers around the map. It's still easy to travel around the map, probably even more so in certain locations, like I was saying. Plus, the drift board only really got put in during the end of Season 7, so a lot of the community are still thoroughly enjoying Season 8. But another factor to take in is just how well Fortnite are responding to the success of Apex Legends. Apex Legends has used a lot of core ideas from Fortnite, like the item shop and free game system. Similarly, Fortnite has used brilliant Apex Legends ideas, like the ping system and the ability to bring back an eliminated teammate. They're not squabbling over who owns what, they're just learning from each other, which in the end is a win-win for everyone. And in number 2, we've got Season 3. The interesting thing about Season 3 is that it probably has the least map changes of all the season. Other than adding in Lucky Landing for the Chinese event, there wasn't really much else changed for the map, which sometimes can be a good thing. As the game was fairly new still, a lot of people were still practicing the game. Now that the map was actually staying the same for a little bit, it gave people a chance to take a moment and learn all the environments properly. They did, on the other hand, introduce a bunch of new weapons for us to play around with. At the season's start, we got the still famous hand cannon, we got the hunting rifle, the light machine gun, the guided missile, and the remote explosives all in that one season. It was hectic, but it was a lot of fun. Without having to focus on the areas, people could get to work focusing on their guns and trying out new things. And the biggest part about Season 3 was the introduction of Fortnite Battle Royale storyline. It filled the community with anticipation, and a comet had been spotted amongst the stars, and as the season progressed, it only got bigger and bigger, so we knew it was gonna hit, and sure enough, we eventually saw fragments of it coming down early, smashing through anything and anyone. And that's when the comet hit and when the Fire Nation attacked. Number 1 is going to be Season 4. The comet had destroyed Dusty Divot, but not only that, but it had taken out the OG factories and even left smaller craters around the edge edge of the map that later grew over time. However, the meteor that hit the center left the crater so big that even to this day, we don't know if it'll ever be fixed. Pretty sure it's part of the map forever now. At the time, it was a complete wasteland. A government laboratory had been set up in the center and hop rocks littered the entire crater. You could consume these hop rocks to gain a low gravity experience for a limited time. They were handy for getting places faster and pulling off some awesome moves. The crater got pretty old quickly, but we also saw a ton more items added. We got epic and legendary variants of the burst assault rifle, the thermal scoped rifle, the dual pistols, and near the very end, the famous drum gun. We got our very first vehicle, the shopping cart, and we even saw some crazy new items like a jetpack and sticky bombs, the new method for the double pump. Needless to say, it was a pretty adventurous season. There was a lot that happened in this season, and in our opinion, the peak of Fortnite. So far, anyway. The best part, our very first in-game event, the rocket launch, we all got to go in-game and have a friendly moment to watch the rocket hit Tilted Towers, only to get it diverted, leaving us a rift in time and space for us to wonder what would happen next in the world of Fortnite. But that has been our list of all the Fortnite seasons ranked from worst to best. Be sure to click that like button if you've enjoyed. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Push notifications on. Be sure to use code T5G in the item shop. Use it and keep it here on Top 5 Gaming.